me back. We're on the set of the soapbox. Soapbox. What is a soapbox? A soapbox you find across in McParland's shop there. A box containing red carbolic soap. Once upon a time, the box was not cardboard as it is today. Once upon a time, the box was wooden. Men who wanted to make a point took it out, stood it upside down when it was empty, stood upon it and talked to the world. Soapbox is here for you on the program. It's here to allow you to give vent to whatever it is in the community that's annoying you, or whatever it is in the community that's making you happy. We want to hear from you on the soapbox. You have 5 minutes, 10 minutes here talking to camera, telling your story. The man who will tell you his story this morning is none other than one of the finest local broadcasters on the island of Ireland, Damien McCulloch.
Well, folks, coming from Rowan Hahn, I take that as a compliment. Rowan, thanks very much. Rowan asked me to do this, and I decided what topic would interest me to talk to anybody, particularly here in the soapbox. People tell me I'm on a soapbox all my life. But I thought about it, and I'd been involved with the Newry and Moran Council Sports Committee for I don't know how many years, and I started to think about it. And I started to think about South Armagh, and I started to think about the new council that's come in. And the whole length of time of the Newry and Moran Council that is here now, that will complete its tenancy probably early next year. 40 years that it's been called Newry and Moran. Never in the title has it ever recognised South Armagh. South Armagh, one of the most mythical areas in the whole of Ireland. We've got two mountains, Camlagh Mountain, Anslieve Gullion, nesting between it, we've got Camlagh Lake. We've got BT 35 when the post office decided to change townlands and call it BT. And everything in BT 35 seemed to get a raw deal. Now my argument here, or my point is, over 40 years, Newry and Moran Council, okay, it had its good bits and it has bad bits, but it never in its title, ever, even if you look at the title, it never recognised South Armagh. I know people say South Armagh isn't Armagh. It's not. It's probably an area that has outstanding natural beauty. It has got poetry. It's got Gaelic football. It's got a life and a vibrancy that maybe no other part of this area has. Bottom line is this. 40 years, Newry and Moran, not once was South Armagh ever considered in the title. Now, I don't want to go on to the new council. I think it's coming up and there are going to be discussions on how they're going to call it or what they're going to call it. Some people say they're going to call it Newry and Moran and South Down. There we go again. No name of South Armagh. So I would put it out there. This is only my just guarded opinion. I think it should be called Gullion, Newry and South Down, because South Down takes in the Morans, Newry takes in the town which straddles Armagh and Down, and then of course Gullion, which is Slieve Gullion, the most mythical mountain in Ireland to an extent. And if you go back through the history of folklore, you'll see it. Corribella's Lake at the top, the mounds, the volcanic rings round Slieve Gullion, all of that. And then, of course, coming out of Newry, we head up the Camlagh Road. I'll give a little bit of a history tour through South Armagh. You have the Egyptian Arch. It's in South Armagh. You go on up into Camlagh, the main route into South Armagh, go on straight through Camlagh, up into Silver Bridge, Mullaban, Cross Maglen, Colliville, Fork Hill, a famous town, a very famous poet is buried not too far from Fork Hill, Padraig O'Doherty, buried down in Orney Graveyard, another legend of old Irish poets. Going over to Craigan, you have Art McCooey buried in Craigan, again another wonderful area of South Armagh. Over to Cross Maglen, I suppose, if you think of the Daily Men in Cross Maglen, the Fair Day in Cross Maglen over many years that straddled both Louth and Armagh, kept people going for a lifetime. Cross Maglen again, maybe due to the troubles and what happened during the troubled time we had here, maybe it was a political decision not to recognise South Armagh in the council area. To me, that's wrong. South Armagh should always have been recognised in it. I go on into Colliville, over right on the very extremities of the area, go back down then into Newtown Hamilton, over to White Cross, back down into Bessbrook, a linen mill, a linen mill, and Rowan has a wee story about linen later on. And again, the people that had worked in Bessbrook over the years in the mill, how the mill was all built up, how Bessbrook came about by the Quakers, the Richardsons and what have you. So all of that history, is in South Armagh. You go over to Killeavy and then you go up to the Sleafgullion Mountain, and on the slopes of Sleafgullion, St. Manina and St. Bridget, and all that in South Armagh. The history of South Armagh has absolutely been phenomenal. We have politicians of a note. We had the great Eddie Richardson, we had Paddy O'Hanlon, we had Harry Lewis, we had all those people from South Armagh, and I'm sure they would have all loved to be said that Newry and Mourne was part of South Armagh. But when you look at the heading of the Newry and Mourne paper, you read about it, it never mentions South Armagh. The Gaelic is very, very strong. Cross McGlenn won so many All-Irelands. Again, Newry and Mourne, of course, they won the Newry and Mourne Sports Awards lots and lots of times. But when you're scratching your head and you're going, Newry and Mourne, these guys come from Cross McGlenn. Another pet hate of mine is when somebody asks me, where do you come from? I put my address down, Camla, Newry, and then you have to put County Down down, BT35, and then you have to put County Down down. It's wrong, folks. I just don't think it's right. And I hope and pray now that Liam Hannaway, who's coming in as the new executive of the new council, he's a South Armagh man. Liam, I'm telling you now, get out there, get talking to the people, ask them for their opinion on the new name. Should it be, well, I went for Gullion, Newry and South Down. Everybody can have an opinion. Let us know what you think. But definitely something of South Armagh should be coming in. And I sort of want to finish, you know, I could talk all day about this, and I could talk about the great people from South Armagh, but I just firmly believe that every person from this area, be it South Armagh, South Down, even further now where we're going away right down to Strangford Lough, you know, you have to be acknowledged. This area has to be acknowledged. You have to have your name. So I'm telling the politicians, I'm saying to the politicians of all creeds, don't care what you are, you have to look at it. Maybe put a poll out there. Don't be sitting up and the council chambers and deciding among yourselves. Ask the people. Let the people decide the name of the new council. Some guy sitting in a salubrious office in Belfast or Stormont or something like that, he does not have the right to do that. The people of this area have the right to call their new council what they believe it should be, and it should recognise the whole diverse area that we have here in this area, in South Armagh, in Newry and in South Down.
There's one fair county in Ireland with memories so glorious and grand, where nature has lavished its bounty. 'Tis the orchard of Erin's green land. Yeah. It's my you're not getting it
no,
yet.
No.
Irish home, far across the foam. And I have often left it. I don't know the rest of the words.
No, but you see, a great song. We sung a wee bit slow. I like the old, the upper
There's
version.
There's one fair county in Ireland with memories so glorious and grand.
Okay, can I stop you there?
In Banbridge town in the County Down July.
Yeah, we're joining across, you see. But what my point was, Rowan, here
I heard it.
It was that...
Couldn't have missed it.
Well, you know, the
You think Liam Hannaway is a fifth columnist? You think he's an agent provocateur going in there to change the name of the council?
No, I don't. But what I'm asking that the councillors sit down, and they're all very educated people, and they know, and there's a lot of councillors from South Armagh and South Down and Newry. All the councillors. You know,
the
we
councillors.
Elect them. Yes, the councillors. We elect
what
them.
What do you call them?
Very educated. Very good councillors.
I think they're a mixed bag. Some are very educated, some are very intellectual, some are less intellectual.
But you see, education, Rowan, doesn't mean you have to go to college to
be
educated. Never went to
college
in my
life.
You can
Not
educate
really.
Yourself in life.
You
but
can.
What I'm saying is that I just believe, I absolutely firmly believe that the South Armagh should be recognised in the new council. It hasn't been in the Newry and Mourne one for 40 years. I think it's 40 years this year.
Yeah.
I think it is anyway. So in the 40 years, South Armagh, maybe it was a political decision. I don't know. But I feel very passionate about it. I come from the area. And I think, you know, I know they did talk about it at some meetings years and years and years ago.
Yeah.
Nothing ever happened. So my appeal again would be, get out there and ask the people.
May I tell you, when I was in the BBC running Radio Current Affairs, in the early days of my tenure there, it was impossible to get an outside broadcast to go into South Armagh. Why? Because the technical unions refused to go there, and that was a consequence of a political bias based on what they perceived to be the nature of the people of the area.
Well, yeah,
and that was something I, in those days, stood against and introduced a program. I know it was out in your area, it was called the Fathom Line.
Yeah.
But I mean, it covered South Ireland.
It did, I remember it well, Rowan, and fair play to you. But you've hit a couple of the points there. Yes, people sitting in areas deciding, okay, we're not going to recognise these people here. And you know, when I sit back and I start to think about it even more deeply now, I start to think that there was dark arts at work behind the scenes to not recognise the area. You know, fine people come from the area. We have legendary poets.
I know it.
And we have culture. We've got games. We've got it all.
I went to South Armagh, to Camlock, to find a woman 60 years ago.
You told me that
and
one.
She did me proud.
Yeah, yeah.
She did. She's a grand woman.
Yeah, and I just all I would ask in this, and it's only a wee soapbox, it's only a wee bit of a rant. And
it's not only a wee soapbox. Well, this is the soapbox.
Well, it's the only soapbox that I know.
Well, it's the soapbox, so and that's it.
I have been very privileged.
It's not just a soapbox.
I'm very privileged to have this opportunity to talk about
Indeed
it.
Indeed you are.
You did ask me what could I come up with, and I thought of it.
There's no doubt about it.
I thought a whole lot of other things to come up, and then I thought this might be maybe the first one. So I decided that, you know, Nuireann Mórn, fine council that it was, and it has its good points and its bad points and everything, but it never once in the name recognise South Armagh.
I think we got that point.
So the new council has to recognise it. So
South Armagh,
Gullion, Newry and South Down. That's my
Gullion. From Gullion to Strangford, the land will be fine. Come and do visits to your place and mine. It's the place to be.
Yeah.
But listen to me, we want people on the soapbox want to tell you that if you have an issue in your head, like this man has, and you want to get it out there, this is the soapbox. So come and join us on the soapbox.
And it is good crack.
It is good crack. We're going to tell them about the Linen Memorial.
Yes, and that's another good story.
It is a good story. Will I tell you about it?
Yes, tell me about it.
Yeah. About 5 years ago, 6 years ago, I went to Corrymeela to do a story on the history of Corrymeela, where people went in order to escape from the troubles. People, Protestants, people, Catholics, from troubled areas of Belfast, they went there and they stayed for a time and they got re-energized there and were able to come back and face the travails of their lives. I went there to do a story, and in that story was the Linen Memorial, done by the Canadian artist Lisia Troughton. And the Linen Memorial is a work of some 400 linen cloths, about that sort of size, each cloth about that size. And the women of the world, under the guidance of the artist, embroidered the names of all the victims of our troubles onto each cloth. Now, I didn't realize that it was a very beautiful situation. I walked into the Cree, which is the subterranean church in meditation center in Corrymeela, with the light streaming, normal daylight, beautiful natural daylight streaming in through the window and illuminating the linen wall that hung there. Little did I know in doing that this coming week the linen wall would be all the way from Canada, all the way from Van Diemen's Land, from Tasmania, all the way from Taiwan, here in Newry in the Dominican church over the road. And it'll be on display there from Saturday evening right through to next Wednesday night. Next Wednesday night, you must be there in the Dominican church in Newry. It's an evening of contemplation, reflection, remembering, with the linen wall at the heart of it. The linen wall hanging there, beautifully lit, beautifully illuminated in the candlelight. And the Dominican Taizé choir singing, Ubi Caritas et amor, ubi caritas Deus ibi est. A quiet time of reflection for rebuilding people after all that we've been through, for people who lost their lives in the time of our troubles, for those people to be remembered, and no one will ever have to say, who are they? That's who they are, and we remember them proudly. So will you come on Wednesday night if you're about?
I won't be there Wednesday night, but I will call in between Wednesday and Saturday.
And see it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's the Linen Memorial, the work of the artist Lisia Troughton. And Lisia will be here in Newry for that time, co-presenting the programme with me next week.